Hello guys, how are you? Good afternoon. This is Victor Anyanwu, your uncle. So today I am having my 10th live broadcast. Yes, my 10th live broadcast. And I'm happy to see you guys here. Thank you for coming. Thank you for joining me. If you can invite your friends to join us, please do. I'm trying to do that right now. I'm trying to invite as many people as I can right now. I think if you can, do the same. Usually we come on every Monday, all right? But, you know, I felt let's try Wednesday. Let's see. We miss some people on a Monday. Let's try Wednesday. Maybe we'll get more people. Maybe we'll help more people, all right? And this today happens to be the, what's it called? The day we celebrate women, yeah? International Women's Day. Okay, so the first person I'm going to celebrate today is my wife, my beautiful wife. Help her, or rather help me thank her. She has been here with all my shenanigans. She has been managing me with all my wala, all my headache, everything that I do, all the wahala I cause. But she has still been here. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, dear. Thank you so much for all your help, for your assistance. Thank you for being here. All right. Now, I'm also going to, thank three more women that we've been working with for a while. One is Tufafi, all right? She is the CEO of Tufafi. Her name is Judith Pamtok, all right? Judith Pamtok Tufafi, all right? Thank you very much. She's an awesome woman. You should see the kind of clothes that she makes, all right? Tufafi.com. If you go to Tufafi.com, you see some really sweet, beautiful clothes, you know, that she has been working on, that she does. She designs beautiful clothes. And I've worked with her, I've been working with her for a while now, and I think she's an awesome woman. All right, so today on the International Women's Day, I am celebrating her. Okay, I am celebrating Tufafi. I am also celebrating Ifoma Aneke of Alo Travels. It's a wonderful travel and tours organization, travels and tours company. I used to tell people that if God was to choose a travel company to go to heaven, let's say on the day we're going to go, God will now say, oh, guys, I want you guys to use a tour company to come to heaven. I'm sure the tour company he will use will be Alo Travels. Okay? He will use Alo Travels. And the CEO, Ifoma Aneke, thank you for being with us. I really want to appreciate that. She has been awesome. Now, finally, I also want to thank the CEO of my perfume shop, NG. Have you gotten this type of perfume that when you spray it, you get so, what's the word? You get so engulfed, right, in the scent. I don't know if you can scent this, you know, but it's so nice that I wish you could scent it, all right? Facebook, I think they're working on something like that where you can sniff someone's cologne. Alright? So they gave me this awesome cologne that has been absolutely wonderful, as in, and I've loved it. Alright. So it's so nice that I am recommending my perfume shop NG. Alright? My perfume shop NG. You can check for them on Facebook. My perfume shop NG. They're on Facebook, they're on Instagram, they're on Twitter. My perfume shop Nigeria. Okay. They sell these awesome luxury perfumes, all right? Name it, whatever perfume from whatever part of the planet, right? Whatever part of the planet. I think they even have Mars perfume and Pluto perfume. You guys should check them out, okay? It's wonderful to smell nice, okay? And they know how to pick it. Okay? They really know how to pick it. So I suggest you pick out perfumes from there. The CEO is Frances Osadebe. Right, she has been awesome. She pulled that company herself for 3 years and running, you know, all alone. No funding, no spiritual backing, you know, just herself, all alone. All right, so big ups to you guys. All right, now today I am talking about how to be everywhere on social media without being overwhelmed. So, how can you be everywhere on social media without being overwhelmed? Pretty simple, be a spirit. Be omnipresent, be God. All right, so today I'm just talking about basically how to be God on social media. So how are you going to be God on social media? there are tools to use, there are systems to use. That's what I do, right? A friend of mine, there was a day we were having a discussion, and while we were talking, he saw a tweet, because he follows me on Twitter, and he saw a tweet by me and was like, okay, you just tweeted. And I was like, I've been talking to you, I'm not with my phone, I'm not with my laptop, I'm not with my, you know, my Mac. So how would I have tweeted? Okay, and he was wondering. I was like, people still wonder how they do these things at this time of the day, all right? But another time, I was with another client, and I was advising her on being everywhere her clients are. And she was like, I can't do that. I have to be here, I have to be this, I have to be that. It's so much work. I was like, okay, well, there are a few things you can do. You probably don't know that you can do them, but if you do them, you'll be everywhere, okay? So what am I saying? What I'm saying is this. There are four things that I use, all right, that have made my life beautiful, okay? So, hey, guys, have you forgotten? Keep sharing. Have you forgotten? Please, 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 don't forget. Keep sharing, okay? Share, share, share. Invite as many people as you can so that they'll join us in this, okay? Now, it's interesting to know that social media can help you to be everywhere. The most important thing about social media is this. You want to be where your client is. You want to be where your market is. You want to be where your audience is. You want to be there at all times. You want to be there at the times when they are available. At the times when, you know, they are there. All right, because I might be on a particular platform and not be there at a particular time, and you will not know that, and you'll probably be tweeting at that time. For example, I'm on Facebook, right? But I'm not on Facebook at 1 a.m., 2 a.m., 3 a.m. So if you want to get me and you try to find me at that time, believe me, I will be sleeping. Do you understand? I will be sleeping. So any spiritual person that wants to get me at that time, you would fail. Why? Because I am sleeping. Do you understand? And that is when most Nigerians sleep, in Nigeria. Okay? But Nigerians abroad at that time, they could be available depending on what part of the country they are. Mm-hmm. But Nigerians in Nigeria at that time are what? Sleeping. Okay? Now, why am I saying this? I have realized that many people share things at the wrong time. Okay? They are available for their clients at the wrong time. They are available when their clients are not available. All right? You won't sell that way. Okay? You want to sell? Be there when they are there. It's like going to the market when the market has closed. Okay? Your clients come to the market in the morning, probably leave by 6 when the market closed. You now wake up by 6 and go to that same market that has closed and expect to sell. The way you do not sell, you think it's a spiritual attack from your grandmother in the village, from one evil forest. Alright? Not everything is a spiritual attack. Alright? Some of them are just your mental attack, your stupidity attack. Pardon my French. Okay? Now, what do I do? Alright? I am on every platform where my clients are. Wherever I find my clients, I am there. I am on every platform where my clients are. So, how do I make myself available for them? Even when I'm so busy, even when I have to attend to meetings, even when I have to hold personal coaching sessions, even when I have to have trainings, even when I have to conduct, do MC, even when I have to be a model, you know, because I'm a model too, you know. So, how am I there? How do I put myself there for them at every point in time? This is how I do it. Number one, the first thing I do is I schedule. Hello, Nikki. Yeah, spiritual attack. These guys, you know, they just do different things. They say different things, all right? Forgive me, but that's just it. It's actually spiritual attack because, you know, people blame lots of things on things that they shouldn't be blaming them on. Okay? You know, you blame everything on this, blame everything on that. You know, you blame so many things on things you shouldn't be blaming anything on. I always say something. If there's an issue anywhere, if there's an issue in your home, if there's an issue in your family, if there's an issue in your office, is there an issue at work, is there an issue with your business anywhere, look inwards first. Make sure that you are free. I wish you would look inward. When you are looking inwards, look inwards objectively. All right. If possible, ask someone to help you look inwards. Okay. Ask someone to help you look inwards. All right. Look inwards objectively. Now, what does that do for you? That would help you see where you are making a mistake or what you are leaving out and what you can fix to improve the situation. Okay. So, as I was saying, I schedule, all right? Scheduling, how would you define scheduling? Scheduling is, okay, let me not tell you about scheduling first, okay? I was going to tell you about scheduling so that I just get that out of the way, but let me not tell you about scheduling first. Let me change the style a bit, all right? I'm going to talk about four things. One is outsource, two is delegate, three is automate, four is schedule, all right? So it's ODAS. As my team guys will love to say, they always like short forms and quotes. So it's ODAS. Alright? ODAS is one. O stands for outsource. D stands for delegate. A stands for automate. S stands for schedule. Okay? So one, you have to do what? You have to outsource. What do I outsource? I outsource things I hate. Things I can't do, things I hate doing, things that stress me, that take so much of my time, and I can just pay somebody to just get it done. I outsource all those kind of things. One of those things is graphics. Graphics kills me. I know how to know great things, but designing it can be such a wahala. So I look for people that can do that. All right. So when I get them or when I find them, I ask them to do it for me, and I can just pay something small. It just saves me. My time is more precious. It costs me a lot more, you know, to do it than to give them. Okay, so when they do, I go, no, I don't like this, do it again. No, I don't like that, do it again. So they keep doing it until I'm satisfied. All right, now outsource things that stress you, outsource things that waste your time, outsource things that will be cheaper for others to do, all right, more expensive for you to do. Outsource, for example, me, I like designing stuff, I like designs, graphics, but as I said, it takes me so much time, so I outsource that. All right, before my company could do websites and all, before we started doing website designs, website development, I used to outsource that. All right, when you just come and you mention, what's it called, and you mention web development, I just tell you, well, we have guys that do it, we can direct you, okay, we can advise you to go to them. I won't do it. But right now, because we can do that, I have guys on my team that can do that, I can now do it. So I can now say, oh yes, I can take that up. Do you understand? All right, thank you guys for coming. Please keep sharing, inviting more people. Okay, now that's what I do now. Okay, I outsource anything I do not like, anything that will waste my time, anything that will waste the time of the company, anything that will reduce time of delivery. I outsource it, because usually we cost you less. There's this platform where you can find guys like Fiverr.com. All right, you'll find guys that will do lots of stuff for $5. All right, how much do I have to waste my time the whole day when I can just pay somebody to get this done for $5? All right, I don't know how much you know time you have and how precious your time is to you or how expensive it is, but for me it's quite expensive, so I try to have more time. Okay, so I'll outsource. Outsource. Now, when I outsource and I get people to do things that I do not want to do or I cannot do, those guys do it and share it on the platforms I have designated, all right? And I appear as if I am there at that time. Some people are like, oh, cool, nice. They like the shot or they like the post or they like the design and they comment and all of that. Sometimes I will not be there. I will not go and comment later, yeah, because I'm busy doing some other things. Do you understand? So outsourcing has helped me, you know, be where I am not. All right, it has given me that omnipresence kind of feel. All right, you know, giving me the full proper name as the Oracle. Okay, now the Oracle is this guy that has answers to social media. Oracle is the guy that has answers to social media issues. Okay, now I am always there because of this thing I'm talking about, all right? So learn to outsource and be available every time whatever platform. Okay, now two is delegate crappy things too. If you are tired of it, if it stresses you too, if you do not want to do it, delegate it. All right, get some other people to help you do it. Delegate. Get okay. Now there are times when it becomes really stressful to post, all right? So I get some other people to manage it. You know, they manage to post the post. I have a few virtual assistants that work with me, so they handle all these posts and it makes my life easy. Then I can focus on more things. All right, delegate what you are not very good in. Delegate what others can do better than you. Delegate what you know, what will cost you more. You know, a few reasons, you know, still somehow the same reasons with outsource. You know, you can basically delegate the same things you want to outsource. Okay, so delegate all those things. All right, now I have a few delegation apps that I use. There's one that I use that is awesome. I don't know whether you've heard of Deliver It. It is dlvro.it. dlvro.it. Now, what that does for me is I can be very busy. I will not have time to check a few sites, to make a few posts about awesome things that my audience are interested in. So what do? I call up Deliver It and I say, "Hey, Deliver It, how are you?" And he says, "Oh, I'm cool." I said, "Okay, please check out these feeds for me. My clients are interested in one. They're interested in social media. They're interested in marketing. All right. They're interested in what are they interested in? They're interested in content. They're interested in, you know, the whole social media family things. Okay. And I now tell this guy, please share things when you see all of these headings." And the guy says, "Yes, sir. Consider it done." And he goes and he checks, all right, checks Google, checks sites, checks all over. Sometimes you might need to give them a few sites to look, all right, so they just check from those sites, or they just help you curate from Google generally, you know. So it's possible you deliver it. Deliver It checks Google and picks out the best for you, okay? Deliver It can check a particular site, and when they put up any great content, they can just pick it and post for you. Now, that is delegation. That is delegation, the kind of spiritual delegation. Do you understand? Yeah, you are actually not delegating to a human being. You are delegating to a machine, to an app. You are delegating to a system. Okay? So, I suggest you take a look at all these things I've mentioned. Deliver It. DLVR.IT. I'll write out, you know, this, the name when I'm done with the video broadcast, okay? But that's it, all right? That's how I deliver, all right? I deliver when you want it. I deliver how you want it. I deliver the value. I deliver the content. And you think I am doing it one. You want to kill me, all right? You know how many companies I manage? I manage lots of companies. They don't want me to mention, but I manage lots of companies. Okay, now when I manage these guys, I manage them on 3, 4, 5 platforms. It's not easy to sit down and look for each one and post. All right, so but what can you do? That's what I'm telling you now. All right, outsource, delegate. Deliver It is a great guy for delegating. All right, even delivers better than mine. Better than my virtual assistants. Yeah, that is secret. Don't tell anybody. Delivers better than many of them. Because sometimes they'll be asking me stupid questions. What's this? Which one is this? Forgive me. Pardon my French. All right. But sometimes they ask some kind of question. I'm like, this is obvious. But Deliver It just knows I need the post. All right. If you don't like the post, you can delete thereafter. Okay. But it's something I think you should consider. All right. It's saving me a lot of time. Okay, for example, right now I'm having guys posting many things right now. We check through my page, check through all the platforms that I belong. So many people are posting things right now. And all the things they are posting. I am here with you, but I'm posting it. Right? It comes in my name and you think I'm the one, but I'm here. Okay, that's why somebody was trying to call me now, because he thought I just posted that. For goodness sake, I'm on Facebook Live. Alright, now the other thing is automate. I automate a lot. Now, what do I mean to automate? To have things just work automatically. They will just connect. They will just do those spiritual things. Do this and just listen to this. All right? You sign up for my ebook and you get an email immediately that, oh, thank you for signing up. This, click this link to get the ebook. All right? You click and you get to another link where you can download the ebook. All of that just happens without me sending you that mail. I have programmed it to work that way. I'm just here having fun with you, and that is happening behind. Okay, learn to automate. One of the best apps for me as regards automating, all right, the best, all right, is IFTTT. IFTTT stands for if this then that. All right, if this then that. Now what does that do? That is an extremely awesome app. I see you guys just don't want to know. It wishes everybody, my followers, all right, it wishes my followers happy Christmas, sorry, Merry Christmas, wishes them happy new year, wishes them happy new month, wishes them what, you know, some beautiful things every day. It does all of that for me, and I'm sleeping most times when it does that. Yeah, I'm sleeping. It'll be wishing you happy new year at 12 midnight. It'll be wishing you happy new month at 12 midnight also. All right, it will be asking you to have a great day at sometime around 6, you know, but I'm sleeping at all those times. So when you see it, you'll be like, this guy, this guy doesn't sleep. Right? I sleep, man. I sleep a lot. But what do I do? I use all these apps to myself omnipresent, to make myself there all the time. Okay? So when you see me and you want to be like me, you're like, man, how does this guy do? You want to be like me. If you follow us, you will die. If you decide to copy me when you see me appear, you will die. Alright, unless you know this behind secrets. That is how I keep it up. Right? That is how I appear. That's how I do all these things. I'm appearing. For example, on IFTT, I post on Instagram. That Instagram post alone goes to Facebook, goes to LinkedIn, and goes to Twitter. So I don't have to bother my head about posting to Twitter, bother my head about posting to Facebook, bother my head about posting to to LinkedIn too. Do you understand? Alright, so that's the way it works. Learn to use all these tools. Alright, learn to use all these tools. They are here available for you. Learn to use them. Alright, IFTT is awesome. Alright, there's this other one that I love. It's called Revive Old Post. It's awesome, as in, it's totally awesome. It was the app that I use on my WordPress. Alright, what it does is, every once in a while, he reposts an old blog post that would have posted. Right? An old blog post that would have posted out a few things. He reposts them. It's awesome. I said, you guys should check this out. It's just fantastic. All right? Mm-hmm. I wish you would check it out. All right? I wish you would check it out. It's awesome. There's nothing you cannot do. You can absolutely, you can tell it to switch off your phone at a particular time. You can just tell it, okay, once it's 6 o'clock, switch off my phone. All right, switches off your phone. You can tell it once it is 10 o'clock, put on my laptop. You know, it just practically does anything you want to do. All right, it can practically do anything. I think you guys should check it out. IFTTT.com. All right, check it out. Check out what you can do with it. All right, if there's any issue, ask me. All right, I'm the oracle, I can help. Okay, now. Finally, schedule. Schedule your posts. Facebook, they're working on this Facebook live scheduling. If I have the information correctly, I don't think it's happening. I don't think it's available for everyone yet, but we are hoping that we'll get it soon. But for me, it's a brilliant idea. For example, I sometimes have meetings on Wednesday with my team. Okay? But today I decided, let me just do this video and forget about the meeting. We'll do the meeting later on. I sometimes have meetings on Wednesdays with my team. Now, when I have those meetings, it is possible to schedule a Facebook Live, have it post today, Wednesday, while I'm having the meeting. Do you understand? So you would watch it live. Meanwhile, I recorded it some time ago. Okay? Then I would be with my team and you think that I'm live. Okay? So scheduling makes life easy. It makes life cool. Alright? And I always advise people to schedule. Okay? It makes you available when you need to be, but you are kind of busy. Alright? It's like how would I put it now? You plan for a post to be posted at a particular time, alright? But at that time, you will be busy with something else, and that post will post. Okay? For example, on Facebook, you can schedule your posts to post whenever, whatever time in the future. Okay? There's a site that I had managed for a little while, so I had scheduled all these posts, alright, for like a month. So every day, you just keep having this post. So even when, okay, there were a few issues, so we had to break the contract that we had. We had to go our separate ways, all right? We had to break the marriage, so we went our separate ways, all right? Myself, my company, and the company we were managing. So when we went our separate ways, because I had scheduled those posts, they were still posting, and the guy was like, we've gone our separate ways, but this guy still likes us so much, and he's posting for us, and we're like, come on, schedule those things, right? But anyway, I was just happy that even if the relationship could not continue, what I had done was still helping them, all right? So you can schedule for as long as you want, okay? It's beautiful, you know, I think you should try it, all right? You can schedule with Buffer, you can schedule with Hootsuite, you can schedule with your Facebook, you can schedule with, just name it, there are several scheduling apps available, but these are the most common ones. Buffer and Hootsuite are very common and very nice. All right, consider them. Okay, schedule. You'll be busy, schedule. You don't have the time, schedule. You are free weekend and you have to post Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, schedule. All right, create your content, schedule. Monday at 6, schedule Tuesday at 6, schedule Wednesday at whatever time, you know, schedule. All right. It saves you time, all right, and it makes you omnipresent. It makes you be everywhere, just as I've said. Okay, four things that save me, all right, and help me be everywhere where I want, when I want to be. All right, one is what? I can't remember. I have to spy. One is outsource. I have to keep. One is outsource, two is delegate, three is automate, four is schedule. Okay, all right. So outsource, have some others do the kind of work you do not like. Delegate, have some other people do the work that you do not like. Now in outsource, you're taking it outside your company, right? You're having some other company do the work. Right? Another company is managing it for you. Another company, you are paying them to do it. Now, in delegation, it's usually someone within your company. It's usually someone within. You delegated it to him. So he does it and manages it for you. All right? Within your company. All right? Now, after delegating, you schedule. Okay? You can schedule with different scheduling apps. IFTT. Okay? You can schedule with... Automate. You can automate with IFTT. You can automate with Revival Post. All right. You can automate with your emails. All right. You have email automating platforms. All right. The person clicks a particular link that you provided, and the link asks for email and name. It provides the email and name, and that link that takes him to a place where he can download the book or download the material, download whatever. He gets to click that to download it, and it takes him to where the book is. You know, meanwhile, we are not doing that. You are just away, relaxed, and all of this is happening. Okay? So, automate, alright? Then schedule. That's the final one, alright? So, this is how I do. This is how I survive. This is how I don't die. This is how I don't get killed. All right. So I think you guys have listened, and it would be nice if there's any comment. I would love to respond. If you have any issues, I would love to tackle them. If there are any questions, I would love to answer them. Okay. But that's how I do it. All right. That's how I do it. That's how I stay alive. All right, and not die. Okay. Now I'm gonna have a free Facebook. Sorry. Oh well, it's a Facebook group training. The free Facebook group training on 4 ways to close sales on social media. All right. 4 simple, fast, rapid ways to close sales on social media. All right. You are selling on social media. You're having problems closing sales. I'm gonna talk about 4 ways to close it fast. Okay. You get the deal and you close it, and you do not lose the client. All right, because sometimes you close the deal and you lose the client. Right, so you will close the deal and you do not lose the client. All right, so 4 ways. All right, so I'll be doing that. I will post the link, the registration link. You can register to that. I'm gonna have that ready for you. Okay. So, are there any questions? I'd like to take questions right now. Any questions? I'm waiting for your questions, waiting for your questions, waiting for your questions, waiting for your questions. So if there are no questions, I'd like to thank you for joining me again today. And let's make a date next week, Wednesday. All right. If we have good followership, lots of people attending, maybe this will be the regular thing. Right? But right now, we are still going. Watch it, checking around, trying to find out which is the best that will work for our clients right now. Okay, which is the best time that will work for you. Right? It's supposed to be long time. Okay, so whatever the case, all right, just let me know what works for you. If Monday works for you, if Tuesday works for you, Wednesday works for you, what time works for you. All right, so that will be available and best time for you. Okay, thank you so much. Remember to read the comments, because I will post the things as regards the events coming up. I want to give you guys that thing. It's going to be a free training. Okay, it's going to be a free training. How to close sales fast on social media. Okay, it's going to be a free training. So it will be in my closed Facebook group. All right, it will be closed Facebook group. Please. It would be good to get any issues that you might be having, or any answers. All right, I'm ready to answer. All right, thank you all for listening. My name is Anyanwu, and they call me the Oracle. You know they call me the Oracle. Cheers.